With me in the studio this morning from Oriole Resources, I'm joined by both Bob Smeeton and Tim Livesey. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Good to see you. Look, annual results out this morning. Bob, before we take a look at those in closer detail, Tim, first off, a couple of words. 2018, I mean, the word transformational, it's overused to some degree, but certainly a year of change for the company.
It certainly was, yes. I mean, not least of which, it was the year that Bob and I joined, so we've really had our hands full. Change to the management, change to the board, new partners, new projects, new funding. It's been a bit of a whirlwind. We managed to get most of the corporate changes done within the first 6 months of us joining, sort of between March and September. And that really allowed us to concentrate as we came into the dry season in Cameroon, September, October, allowed us to concentrate on our exploration to deliver some results. So the name change to Oriole in September was kind of the cap on that. I think, as you'll see when you speak to Bob about the finances, we've had a big focus on financial control, fiscal discipline, but we've managed to do that in the front end, and we've been able to get the teams back focused now on doing what we do best, which is, you know, boots on the ground exploration.
Indeed. Bob, talk us through some of the numbers.
Yeah, sure, Andy. So the key operational loss figure is 2.5 million, which compared to 7.5 million in the prior year. And the thing in there really is the administrative expenses. We got down 26%, which is the fiscal discipline that Tim talks about. And the reason being really to focus what we do on our exploration. And, you know, admin costs we have to keep very strictly under control. The big news, I guess, during the year was the resolution of the long-running VAT dispute, where we're expecting about £500,000 back quite shortly from HMRC. And the key thing for 2019 is we've had a lot of professional advisor fees in 2018 relating to that dispute. So those drop out. That's nearly £200,000 a year saving. So the admin expenses themselves will come down even further during 2019. And then the other thing that people focus on is cash at bank and incoming funds. And we talked about the HMRC money coming back. We've got 1.3 million at the year end cash in bank, which funds us through the next stages of our exploration programs. We also recently announced $500,000 coming in from one of our Turkish partners.
That's right.
From a success-based fee arising from their taking over the Courage project. And we also announced quite recently, just a small amount, but quite nice to get, was a research and development credit. We got £40,000 back, again from HMRC, relating to 2016's research and development work. And we've got follow-up claims to do for 2017 and 2018. So we've got cash at bank and we've got money coming back in. So we're in a pretty strong position.
Well, certainly encouraging to see the cash position strengthening.
It is, when you consider we've been spending money in Cameroon. Obviously, Dalafin were carried. The IAM Gold JV, they're earning in their 8 million spend. So we don't have any real expenses related to Dalafin, other than some administrative costs for our West African exploration manager, ISIF. But it means we're in a strong position getting cash back in, a strong position cash in the bank. So we believe we've delivered certainly what we'd planned to deliver as a team and what the investors expected, which was fiscal discipline, focus on boots on the ground geology, some real wise heads to drive the exploration forward, and continuing to do more of the same in 2019.
And as far as what we're on the lookout for, what we're expecting, we're waiting on some results from Cameroon?
We are. We've got the soil sampling program at Wapuzi that's outstanding. We have the remaining trench samples coming out of Bibemi as well. We announced last week results from 13 of the trenches, 22 in total. So there's some more results to come out of there. Those are still in with the labs, so it'll be a while before we get those. But we're hoping still within Q1. Perhaps drifting into early Q2, but certainly in line with our plans and our predicted timeline. News flow out of Senegal will be at the pace of IAM Gold's program. We've announced the program, 13,000 meters of air core and RC drilling. So we are, you know, we'll be seeing results from that through the year as they progress. So yeah, there's quite a lot going on. Yeah.
And looking slightly bigger picture, what are you hoping to come out of 2019?
Well, you know, we've got a stable base now. You know, we have the legacy assets in Turkey that are returning some cash now. We still have royalties on three JVs out there. We have some additional cash coming in, small amounts coming in, as Bob said, on research tax refunds and so on. So the rest of 2019, obviously, focus on Cameroon. That's our main play. And results coming in from Dalafin. But we're obviously now getting ready for the next stage. We've got a firm base now, a firm foundation. Company's running smoothly, good team, good board, good management. So now what's next on the horizon? You know, new assets possibly. We're looking around. We're constantly talking to partners. We're constantly talking to people with interesting ground positions that we might be wanting to develop a relationship with, or perhaps get involved, or get some asset swaps or asset takeovers, or it's all to play at the moment. We've committed to staying in the Africa and European time zones, so that's where we're looking. But exactly what we deliver, we'll just have to see what shakes out of the tree over the next couple of months.
Well, of course, we're seeing the strengthening gold price, plus some M&A action too, so a bit of activity in the space.
There is. I mean, the M&A activity is right at the top of the space. we're not quite at the Barrick and Randgold level of market cap just yet, but it's pleasing to see that there's activity. One of the things, obviously, whenever there's mergers of larger companies, things fall off the table. So there's always opportunities to look around it, and we do have we've had some good conversations with people at various levels in the industry about assets that may be freeing up and so on. Gold price rise is always good. We also, we have exposure to copper as well through some of our Turkish assets. And we have skills that cover both copper, gold, base metals. So we're looking in that sort of space. I think if you look at where Oriole can get to, I think we've got as I said, we've got a firm base, we've got a good team, we've got a good focus. Don't be surprised if we don't come back with some more news before year end. I'm sure there'll be interesting things happening.
Very good. Well, Bob, nice set of numbers this morning. A good time to be part of Oriole and the story.
Oh yeah, excellent. Yeah, I mean, I joined in June, and it's been an interesting baptism into the mining industry, to say the least. We're very pleased to be here. A great team of geologists, loads of experience, and lots of exciting projects going on, and opportunities for us, and financially stable as well, which is all good.
Really good to see you both. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew.